truth, going against, you know, my favorite player, Kobe. So, you know, just giving him fits, and I have a picture saved of Kobe walking off, and, you know, all the green confetti. You know, this is back before I came to Celtics. I just want to mention that. you know, Kobe's walking off the floor, and, you know, I go home, and I rewatch the highlights of you know, games 1 through 6, and, you know, you see the, I think it was game, whatever game it was at L.A., Pierce had that black leather knee brace on, and he just put on an unbelievable show in front of his hometown crowd, and, you know, he just always rose to those occasions, so just consistently wanting that shot, wanting that possession, and then you just saw him just flourish when he had other great players around him. You know, it was just those first few years he was trying to get there, you know, struggling a little bit, which all young players do, and then he got some dogs around him, and they just elevated him, and it's so awesome to see, you know, somebody of you know, that talent, you know, be elevated with other great players, and you still see how much he separated himself from everyone else. So, you know, whatever the team needed, Doc gave him the green light. It's not like he needs the green light to shoot anyway. So, you know, as you can hear, I'm a fan. I've been a fan for a long time. I'm a fan of a lot of greats, but, you know, his legacy will live on forever on Sunday, where his jersey retired with a lot of other great players that played within the organization around the league.
Have you had the chance to communicate much with Paul since you became Celtic?
No, not as much, This is also new to me, so I know that I'm part of it. For almost a forever fraternity now that I'm Boston Celtics, so I think I should start using that card a little bit more.